If you would like to add a watermark to your photo as it's being exported, then go into the watermark section and check that watermark box. If you have a preset created, you can select it from the list, or you can go down to edit watermarks to make sure that you have watermarks that look good specific to these photos. I'm going to resize this so we can see more of those settings. Just like some of the other things inside of Lightroom, you can either do a text or a graphic watermark. Once you click on that graphic watermark, a window pops up where I would just choose the watermark that I wanted to use. I'm going to cancel that because I'm just going to work on a text watermark for now. In the text option, you can choose your font weight, or your style. And you can also choose the alignment if you have it centered in the photo, for example. You can even change the color. I like to keep mine white. And if you want to add a shadow behind it, it's not really showing up very well in this image, but if I use these arrows at the top, I can scroll through and see what it looks like on different images. Using a shadow helps it stand out from the background, especially if it's a lighter background. In this case, it doesn't have any trouble being visible. And these settings are WYSIWYG, so you can actually see those changes being made. The bottom section, I think, is kind of one of the more important ones. It's where you position the watermark itself. I usually set my opacity kind of low. I don't like my watermarks to be too intrusive when I actually end up adding them to my photos. And you can change the size, and if you have that proportional radio box checked, then it's just going to be proportional to whatever image you have. So if I make a really big watermark, it's going to appear to be the same size regardless of the photo that I'm working on. If I set it to fit, then it's just going to fit in that image and fill. It just fills it up there, and that looks kind of weird. So I'll keep it with proportional, and I'm going to move that size down a little bit. I'm going to jump to the bottom here, and this is where you anchor the watermark. By default, it's in the bottom left corner, but I can move it to the right or to the middle or the top right or just off to the side. And then once you have it in the position you want, this is when you'll want to play with the inset. This helps kind of move it off to the side, even off the frame if for some reason you wanted that. It just gives it some padding so it's not tucked up right up next to the edge of that frame. And you can even rotate it as well. And the bottom is where you will type and add what you want your watermark to say. And when you're finished, go ahead and save this as a new preset. I like to create my preset with whatever text is in there so I know what it is when I'm choosing it from the list, and then click Create, and then go to Done. And now when you export those photos, that watermark will be embedded into those images. And then last but not least, we have the post-processing section. Most often, you'll probably have this set to do nothing after export. That just means that the photos are going to export to whatever location you chose. But if you want, you can show them in that folder and it'll pop up as soon as you export those photos, or you could even open them all into Adobe Photoshop. If you have another application that you'd like to open those photos into, you can choose that option and then select it from your applications on your computer.